Sumners, 18 years old, from the Seattle Skating Club. And Rosalyn, at this moment, is tied in second place with Kristina Wegelius. And we're going to have to wait for a moment or two after she's finished to have the computer tell us whether or not that tie will be broken and in whose favor.
John, Rosalyn is the one that could take the gold medal here at Skate Canada, although she is in second place. Look at her opening moves again. Those double axels, that very quick rotation in the air, total control. Here's the second one. Same thing.
One thing you notice right away about Rosalyn's skating is the strength of her step. She really moves when she's out there. Double left.
Rosalynn might be the most improved young skater in the world today, because just 2 years ago she was the junior world champion. Here she is in Skate Canada, looking like she was in first or second in the world.
Straight into a double axel and right into a camel spin. Rosalyn is another example where she likes to do one move like the spiral and tie it straight in to the triple saka, which he has planned right here from a back edge. She opened up a little bit, did a double, but that's her prerogative to do that, of course.
Interesting to watch how people go in and out of jumps, because that's what adds variety to a program.
There's been a great battle going on in the United States with Rosalynn Sumners and Elaine Zayak. Now, Zayak is the world champion, and then Sumners beat her in the U.S. Nationals. And I think this is going to be a great battle when they get back to the U.S. Nationals this year, because Rosalynn won Skate America. Looks very much as though she could win Skate Canada.
Oh, Knowles done a triple toe. No idea what happened there, John. She just had no control on the landing, obviously. Again, that threw her off. That is most unfortunate.
She seemed to be going well through the beginning part of her program.
Don't know what happened. That fall on that triple toe loop, of course, threw her off when she went into a relatively simple jump, the double axel. She went down for the second time, and she's obviously going to be disappointed with this. Now we can have a look at some of her jumps earlier. The double axel jumps, 2.5 revolutions. And that was the one she fell on at the end of the program. She had no difficulty with that there. Here's the second double axel. So she did two double axels at the beginning beautifully. And then, of course,
Here we'll see one of her combinations. That's an Ina Bauer into a double axel. Watch how her free leg comes through on the double axel to get that great height of the jump. Very well done. Somewhat similar to Brian Orser in how he lets that free leg come through before he does the rotation.
I don't know just how much they're going to take away from her for those two falls at the end there. It is for technical merit. It'll be the first mark we'll see, and of course it could hurt. At that point, I spoke too soon, but she looked like she was home free.
She looked great. She was skating with a lot of pep and control and confidence, and then that triple toe loop just at the very end of the program. I'm still not quite sure what happened.
She's shaking her head because she doesn't seem to know either.
It happened so quickly. She seemed to have taken off all right, Lynn. She went up into the air. It was on the landing, and maybe we'll have another look at it in slow motion. Here it is now. Let's watch for it. She puts her toe in. She's pretty straight in the air, but her free leg, I think, was wrapped up around her, and when she landed, she just couldn't possibly get out of it.
And that is disappointing because the first set of marks show a 4.8. However, she does range up to a 5.6 from the number five judge from Japan. That's quite a spread.
There's no chance now, John, for her to move into that first place position, which she was shooting for. And out of her four-minute programs, 33 and a half minutes into it, she still had a possibility of moving into first place. But those two falls at the end, of course, removed any opportunity of that.
Now the mark for presentation ranging from 5.0 to 5.5. And then at 5.5 comes from the American judge.
Judge number six.